guys, thanks for coming back to join me again for another video Bible lesson. We have a really good story today about a man named Stephen. We also have a fun puppet show coming up for you. But first, I want to make sure to remind you about our building contest. You can use Legos or Mega Block or regular building blocks. You can even go outside and put together some mud and make a big mud pie or a castle, whatever you want to do. But just send me a picture or video of your favorite build of a church or a Bible lesson to kidsministry@kirkmont.org. Now, my kids ended up making a build that they're going to show you in just a moment. But first, I want to tell you, if you watched last week's Bible lesson and you saw what they started building, what they ended up building is a little different than what they started building. We have a little girl staying with us who came through and destroyed all of their creations, so they had to start over again, but what they ended up making is really cool. And here it is.
We decided to walk together because this dam climbed on the table and destroyed our Lego creations. So we decided to walk together to take this Lego creation.
This is the toy of Noah's Ark, and this is Noah. And these are the animals. These are
ostriches. If that's the cow, that's the unicorn.
That's gonna be the peacock.
Then
those are the hippos. That's the panda, and that's the rhino. That's Mom. The snail. And as Ian said, that's Noah and his helper. Noah is a important one of the Bible because he protects the animals. And the story of Noah is a very important lesson. So, thank you for being here. Have a nice day. Thank you.
Hey, what'd you guys think about that? Pretty cool, huh? I know I thought it was. They did a great job, and I cannot wait to see what amazing creations you send in. Don't forget, you have until the end of May to send your pictures or videos to me, and I'm excited to see them. Well, hey, let's get to our Bible lesson now. Remember how last week we talked about one of Jesus' friends named Peter, who first pretended he didn't even know Jesus, but then after he heard that Jesus rose again from the dead, and after he saw Jesus, he believed and he was given God's amazing power to do miracles? Well, I also mentioned that others of Jesus' friends were able to have God's power too. And they went around doing all kinds of amazing things in Jesus' name, like raising people from the dead, healing people who were blind or couldn't walk. That group of people who went around doing those amazing things began to be called the church. And so did everyone else who believed in Jesus. So there were so many new people who became a part of God's church, a part of his family. One of those people was a very important man named Stephen, and we're going to talk about him in our Bible lesson today. Hey guys, have you ever touched a hot stove before? I hope not. If you haven't, don't try it. Very bad idea. Why do you think it would be a bad idea to touch a hot stove? Well, because it's hot. If you touch it, it's going to burn your hand and it's going to hurt. It's going to bring you pain. Usually in our lives, we try to avoid things that will hurt us and bring us pain and suffering. But you know what? Jesus said that anyone who follows him will experience some pain and suffering. But he also told us that he would be with us, that he would be right there by our sides through any pain and suffering that we experience. And you know what else he said? He said that if we experience suffering and pain for him because of following him, that God would bless us. Now, the man in our Bible lesson today experienced more pain and suffering than most people do for Jesus. He was even killed because of how much he loved Jesus and how much he kept telling other people about Jesus. We can read about Stephen in Acts chapter 6 and 7. Let's look at his story now. Now Stephen, a man full of God's grace and power, did great wonders and miraculous signs among the people. Oh my goodness, that man looks really sick. I wonder what Stephen's going to do. Hooray, he's healed. There they go. Oh no, looks like there's another sick man coming. He looks really sick. He's covered with sores. What's Stephen going to do? Hooray, he's healed. Yay! Not everyone liked what Stephen was doing, though. These men began to argue with Stephen, but they could not stand up against his wisdom or the Holy Spirit by whom he spoke. Then they secretly persuaded some men to say, "We have heard Stephen speak words of blasphemy and lies against Moses and against God." So they stirred up the people and made them really angry. Then they seized Stephen and brought him before the leaders. When they brought Stephen before the leaders, they produced false witnesses who testified and told lies about him. But all who were sitting there looked intently at Stephen, and they saw that his face was like the face of an angel. Then the high priest asked him, "Are these charges true?" To which Stephen said, "Yes, they are, and Jesus is God." When they heard this, they were very angry with him. But Stephen, full of the Holy Spirit, looked up to heaven and saw the glory of God and said, "I see heaven open and Jesus standing there at the right hand of God." At this, they covered their ears, and yelling at the top of their voices, they all rushed at him, dragged him out of the city, and began to throw stones at him. While they were stoning him, Stephen prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he fell on his knees and cried out, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." When he had said this, he died. And a young man named Saul was there, who had been holding the clothes for the people, and he thought what they were doing when they stoned Stephen was very good. Stephen strongly believed in Jesus' power. In fact, he had so much faith that Jesus was God and that Jesus had God's power that he was willing to be killed by those bad people rather than pretend that he didn't know Jesus. And in fact, he even believed in God's power so much that he knew Jesus could bring him to heaven after those people killed him. Now, our puppet friends have a fun song for us today about God's power, so let's take a listen.
So big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the rivers are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. Hey, hey. Here's another one. My God is so great, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. That's right. My God is so great, so strong, and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. Ha ha. The mountains are his, the rivers are his, the stars are his handiwork too.
That's right, puppet friends. Our God is so big, so strong, and so mighty, there is absolutely nothing that he cannot do. And because we know that Jesus is God, we can trust in Jesus that if we confess our sins, if we tell God about all the things that we've done wrong, that Jesus will forgive us of all of our sins if we ask him to. And he promises to always be with us. So we can trust in him for that. That no matter what happens to us, even if by telling people that we love Jesus, even if they tease us or they do mean things to us, even if they hurt us because we love Jesus, we can trust God that he is in control and there's nothing that can happen to us unless he lets it happen. So we can trust that no matter what, he will always be with us. He even has the power to change people's hearts and lives. Remember the man named Saul that we read about in our Bible lesson today? Well, Saul ended up becoming the Apostle Paul. And the Apostle Paul is someone who is one of the most famous people in the Bible because of how much he loved Jesus. So God's power and Jesus' power took a man named Saul from being someone who was really happy that the people were killing Stephen because he didn't want anyone to become a Christian. He didn't want anyone to hear the message about Jesus, to being a man who went all over the whole world and told everyone about Jesus. That is just how powerful God is. That is just how much God loves the world and wants us all to hear about Jesus. So let's pray and thank God for his amazing power. Thank you so much, Father, for this great day, this fun Bible lesson that we got to have today. I thank you so much for your power. I thank you that you sent your son Jesus to earth to die for our sins, that if we believe in him, that we can have forgiveness and we can go to heaven someday to be with people like Stephen and people like Paul, people who loved you and followed you with their whole hearts for their whole lives. I pray that we would be people like that. And I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I had a really fun time with you guys today. I enjoyed our Bible lesson. I hope you'll join us next week for our next Bible lesson. And also, don't forget, please send in your pictures and videos of your builds. I would love to see those. Send those to kidsministry@kirkmont.org. You can find more of our fun videos on Facebook and YouTube. Just search for Kirkmont Church. And if you want to watch one of our sermons, you can tune in at 9 a.m. on Sunday mornings, and those sermons will be live streamed on Facebook and YouTube and our website, kirkmont.org. So I hope you guys had a great time. I know I did, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye!